As a sysadmin, you have bad days. You know, annoying users, IT downtime, or cleaning a coffee-stained keyboard. And then you have really bad days. Like arriving at work to hear sirens in your office building and learning that your server room is the cause of the alarm. Here's the story of Michael and how he ended up having to cool an overheated server room using ventilation fans.
I'm Michael and I worked as a sysadmin. It's now 3 years ago, and I was responsible mainly for the virtual environment at our 18 locations worldwide. I was also responsible for the storage systems and therefore, of course, also for the hardware in the data center.
The data center was pretty much like a server room you'd find in any company, except that it had previously been an office and even had a window to show for it. And of course, the window was configured so it would set off an alarm when opened. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. As with any data center, it was important to keep the server room cool, since the servers would automatically shut down if a certain temperature was exceeded. To keep it cool, it was equipped with standard but very ancient air conditioning units. It was designed redundantly with a main and backup AC unit. The AC worked by pulling the air under the floor to cool it down before bringing the cool air up in front of the server racks to cool them down. But because of the age of the AC units, there was a problem.
Well, we couldn't directly monitor the AC units because there was no network interface. So we added a third-party temperature sensor, which we included in PRTG, and so we could see what is the temperature in the data center.
Even before the day of the incident, there were already some signs of the impending disaster.
And one day we got a notification from PRTG that the temperature rose in the server room, and we directly went there and we found out that the main air conditioning system had a problem. So the backup system started, cooled the server room down, stopped at the defined temperature, the server room was heating up again, and the backup system started again and cooled it down. So it was like a circle. Then we decided to constantly stop the main air conditioning system so that only the backup system was running, and so the temperature was at a normal level after, I think, 30 minutes.
And so, because of the backup air conditioning unit, Michael was not concerned.
We went back to our office and I called the technician to have a look for the system the next day, and everything seems fine again.
As worry-free as Michael was, that would all change the moment he arrived at work the next morning, when he noticed the building alarm was going off. We're about to get into his story, but first, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel.
Well, I could already hear the siren when I arrived at the parking space, and I directly ran into the building to find out what happened during the night. When I opened the door from the server room, I could already feel the heat from the server room on the door handle. The first thing we wanted to do was to stop the siren of the alarm system. And therefore we had to go inside the server room and we had to add a special pin on a number pad at the wall. And we didn't know the code, so we had to look at the documents, what was the code. And in this situation, it is loud, it is hot, you're stressed, and well, after a few minutes, we found the code, and so we could stop this loud siren.
But what had triggered the building alarm? It turned out that one of Michael's colleagues had opened the window in the server room to let in the cool winter air, and that set off the security alarm. But why had the server room overheated in the first place?
Well, we stopped the main system the day before, and during the night, the backup system had also a problem. There was not enough cooling fluid, and so the system stops stopped working completely.
The consequence of these servers shutting down was, of course, that many IT services were no longer available. Michael's team obviously wanted to get the systems up and running as soon as possible, and that meant they first needed to cool the server room down.
We realized that opening only one window is not enough to cool down the server room. So we had to find another solution, and the idea came up to have a look in the building for available fans. The idea was to put five or six fans in one row to get the air from the outside into the server room. And so we started to install all the fans. It was such a lame idea, but it worked.
Within a few hours, the server room had cooled down enough for them to be able to restart critical servers and get basic IT services up and running step by step. And then later, the technician arrived to repair the AC units.
Yeah, I can imagine that he was also laughing about our solution to how to cool the server room if the air condition fails.
Of course, things have changed in recent times to enable better monitoring of AC units.
Nowadays, it's easy to add a new air condition system to your network because they have a network interface and you can easily monitor them. If you're still using older units, PRTG supports protocols like Modbus TCP or MQTT, or you can also use a gateway to connect your older system to the network and so integrate it to your monitoring system.
Bad days in the office, like this one, invariably give SysAdmins experience for dealing with problems in the future. And the same goes for Michael. So what were the lessons learned for Michael?
My lessons learned, first and foremost, monitor your AC systems. Do tests on your backup AC system regularly. And thirdly, these are the days you will remember your whole life.
If you want to know how to use the Modbus TCP sensor of PRTG that Michael mentioned, check out the tutorial in the end card. Also, we'd love to hear your SysAdmin stories in the comments.